Okay, so just 1 second. And okay, so 3, 2, 1, go. Oh shit! 1 sec. I forgot the sound is off. Okay, so now it's good. Okay, so hello everyone. I'm Shadex, and this is Cave Story. This is a indie game. You've probably heard of it. It was released around 2004 by a dude named Pixel. And it's actually a quite popular indie game, and it's really good. That's also a reason why it's in the marathon, right? And here I just got my first weapon in the game. It's called the Polar Star, and in this game, there is a level system for each weapon that you can see on the top left corner. So right now my weapon is level 1, and I will be able to level it up by grabbing some XP from enemies. So XP is those little triangles. I just died! That's the first death, nice. That was the death I was hoping not to get, but it happened. So we get to see the first cave again. So enjoy it. It's really good. Oh, yeah, it's not Cave Story Plus from Steam, this is the original version. The difference between the original and Cave Story Plus is that the game runs at 50 FPS. The original, sorry, runs at 50 FPS, and the Plus version runs at 60. But speedrunners mostly run the game on the original version, so there's like more competition, I would say, and it's basically more interesting. And in general, most of the skips in Cave Story Plus are either different or harder to do. So I just finally got out of the first cave. Also, worth mentioning, the game is in Japanese, as you can see, and this is because it's much faster than English. I'm not exactly sure about the difference, but I've heard it was about 5 minutes, so this is quite a substantial time save. No fish boost. Okay, so during the entire speedrun, you will see me jump quite a lot, and this is because being in the air makes you go 5% faster, so I'll try to jump as much as I can. Worth noting is that this game is also very mashing heavy. There's a lot of text to go through, and you probably can hear my keyboard right now because I'm mashing like crazy. And here's the first boss coming up, about to start, and done. It was a good fight. Okay, so here's the first instance of RNG in this game. So here are a bunch of mushrooms. They move in a completely different pattern, like it's completely random. So I have to adapt to their movements, and I got decent RNG, so I take it. You can get easily screwed up by them. Alright. So I'm about to enter what we call the up corridor, and it's also... I need to heal, okay. It's also a lot... how do I say this? Like, RNG dependent, like the first part of the up corridor, because I need a lot of XP and I need my weapon to be at level 2, at least. And I'll take this. And we got it, so we're good to go. And I will try to hopefully get a skip in order to save a few seconds where I stand on... Oh my god, I got the reverse! Okay, so I was supposed to ride these bugs to the right side of the screen, but they are bringing me to the opposite direction, so that's great. It's really rare, by the way. So we get to walk through this again. Yeah, most speedrunners of Cave Story use keyboard. It's just a preference, by the way. It's not like it's faster or anything. I just prefer speedrunning this game on keyboard because it's easier for mashing. Okay. So my XP is looking kinda good. Die. Okay. No, dude, I'm not a professional. As you can see, I died in the first cave. Alright, first real boss. Like, for real, this one. Oh shit, I mashed too fast. Okay, good. He's dead. So what I was doing there was jumping as soon as he was about to hit me. You can stand in the middle of him. He doesn't have a hitbox. So that's cool. By the way, the world record for this game is 5711 by a Japanese runner named PPU, and it's quite good, I have to say. Improvable, but quite good. Oops. Okay, so as you can see, there is a bug behind me, and I'm not killing him because I will need him for a damage boost here in order to get this health upgrade. There are a bunch of health upgrades in this game, and I will only take a few of them, not all of them, because some of them are like either too far from me or not necessary for the speedrun. As you can see, there is one in the bottom here, but I'm not gonna take it. So next area is gonna be Grass Town, and in Grass Town there's a completely useless item I can get, and during marathon runs we usually do like donation incentives, like get it or don't get it. So here I'm just gonna ask chat if you want me to get this useless item or not. It's like a lipstick, and the next one is gonna be a panties. Dude, same. He never streamed. Grass Town. It has good music, but I'm not a big fan of it, honestly. I don't really like the area as well. You can mess up easily. Whoosh! Okay. Okay. We're good. We're not good. I'm gonna heal, don't worry. Okay. I can see a yeah, so I'm gonna get it. Just for you, Mr. The Shrug. Oops. Okay, so here I get my second weapon, called the Fireball. Bowl. Ball. And it follows along the ground quite easily, and I will use it a lot in this area. And here I just leveled it up to level 2. It's gonna be very useful for next bosses. Okay, so here's Chaco. She's really cute, and here she's standing by this bed, and I wanna sleep. I'm really sleepy right now. So if you sleep when she's very close to the bed, you can hear an item get like sound, and you can see her sleeping in the bed, and you have her lipstick. So yeah, whatever happened there probably happened, but I don't know what. So that's a completely useless item, just so you know. Also, yeah, you in this speedrun, you use the machine gun because, as Zex mentioned, you can keep booster momentum very easily, and it's gonna speed up the speedrun quite a lot towards the end once I get the booster. Okay, I'm saving here because there's a bunch of skips that are quite hard to get. Here's the first, and I didn't get it, unfortunately. I was trying to reach this platform I'm standing on right now, but I couldn't, and I had to go around, basically. Okay, here's the next big skip. I'm gonna do it first, and then I will explain it. Alright, got it. So this is called the Chaco House Skip. And I was able to skip a part of the fetch quest by deboosting from the butt twice in order to reach a high platform. And in order to do that, I had to open my menu to reset my iframes to be able to get hit twice and reach the platform. It's quite hard to pull off. Requires quite some practice. But it's a really useful skip, and I would say it probably saves a minute, probably. Look at this mad robot. Alright, this was Balrog. I was standing on top of his head and mashing with fireball. You don't get hit if you stand on his head. Oh shit. So it speeds up the battle quite a lot. Okay, here I'm about to pick my third weapon in the game. It's called the Missile Launcher, and I could have actually picked it up earlier in Ecoridor, sorry, but it's faster to get it here. And it's a weapon I will use a lot in the next area and against a few bosses. Here I'm aiming to get it to level 2. And I got it, so that's nice. Because I will abuse of it in the next area. Alright, another boss. Hopefully I will get a 3-round fight. So this is a giant frog, in case you didn't notice, obviously, I had to point it out. Whoa. Okay, 114, that's good. I should be able to get 3 rounds. Yep, okay, got it. Like, the damage you deal to him each round is kinda random, and you can sometimes get a 4-round battle and sometimes 3-round. Okay, so here you just saw me going with quite a lot of speed. It's because I was pushed by a fan, and it boosts you with a lot of speed, and what I was doing was jumping as soon as I was touching the ground in order to keep my momentum. This is a thing that will come into place later in the game, and it's important to keep it in mind. This is a thing in this game where you like keep horizontal momentum by jumping on the ground, but the more you touch the ground, the more you decelerate, so there's also that. Never blink. This is a speedrun right now. Insane speed. Bloodlust. Nice emote. Okay, so now I will backtrack to the beginning of this area, and we'll go on to the next one. Some good XP right here. So earlier I mentioned that I needed level 2 missile launcher. It's because in the next area there are some enemies called Polish, I think. Yeah, Polish. And they can die with only 2 missile of a level 2 missile launcher. And if you don't use level 2 missiles, they die in a different way. Basically, they are like giant sun-like shaped enemy, and when you kill them, he divides himself into smaller, like, sense. You will see what I mean. It probably doesn't make any sense right now, but you will see what I mean. Alright, more cutscenes. This was probably the longest one, I think. Anyways. Sand Zone. Something I think I didn't mention is that, like, right here my weapons have a certain level, but if I get hit, they will de-level, so I have to be careful with a bunch of enemies, especially in this area, because most of them do way too much damage, and I might easily lose my weapon level. Alright, so here's Curly, but she's already dead. Use Fireball against her. She asks her if we're gonna kill her, but we say no. And here she is asking us if she wants to if you want to trade your weapon with the one she has. And we say yes, because the weapon she has is much better than the one we had. Okay, here I'm gonna get her panties. Here they are. They were very well hidden. And again, this is a completely useless item. I have really good XP, that's quite nice. Okay, so here are the enemies I was talking about. So yeah, I was saying that they were like sun-shaped enemies. And here I shoot two missiles to them and they instantly die. Otherwise they would divide into multiple, like smaller versions of them. And it's quite annoying to deal with. And they give a lot of XP as well, so I take advantage of that. And here's another boss called Omega. Again, I'm gonna use Fireball here. I just stand by him and just smash. I destroy these. And I finish him. Done. Yeah, exactly, Nero. Also, during the fight, I got a level 2 machine gun. Okay. Dude, these polishes are annoying right now. Okay. So, machine gun is a really useful weapon in the speedrun. And it's because at level 3, it allows you to fly. And my XP right now is looking very good, so I will very soon get it to level 3. Okay, so here's the part where I have to do a little fetch quest. This old lady is asking me if I can find all her dogs. She has 5 or 6, I can't remember. And so we're gonna go on a quest to find all of them. Okay, here I have level 3. And here's another dog. Hope I can catch him. Okay. And during this little fetch quest, I will try to level up all my weapons to level 3 basically, max. And right now it's once again looking very good. I should be able to get them at max soon. And another health upgrade. So in a like PB attempt, I would not take any more health upgrade, but since this is a marathon, I might get a second one later, but it all depends on how the one of the boss fights go. Okay, all my weapons are at max, so I'm gonna do some damage boost here. In this screen there's a lot of birds. And so I just deboost off of one of them and I just go through the others. I was supposed to tank that hit with my fireball, but I didn't. But this is... no worries, this is all good. And this is the second to last one, so there's one more, and this... okay, 5 of them. I thought it was 6 for some reason. So, next room here. Everything is completely dark, but I'm a speedrunner and I know where the platforms are, so this is 3. Okay, here I'm gonna get an item called the Life Pot. It's gonna allow me to... like, when I use it, it's gonna heal me to full HP, basically. And it's gonna be very useful in the latest area. If you know this game, you know that the final area of the game is quite difficult. And depending on how it goes, I might use my life pot. So I guess I can talk about endings in this game. There are a bunch of different endings, exactly 3 of them. And I'm going for the best one, and going for the best ending requires you to go through a harder last cave, I'm gonna say. Like the true final dungeon of the game. And Yeah, that's why I picked that life pot. Otherwise, in PB attempts, I don't use it. But it makes it really hard. No, this is not the Steam version, this is the original version. Also, just so you know, the original version is actually free. Alright, good fight. So, during this fight, I was... While she was standing on the ground, I was mashing my fireball, and then, after a small moment, I shoot missiles to force her to jump, because for some reason when you shoot missiles at her, she immediately jumps. So I take advantage of that, so that when she jumps and she, like when she's in the air, I use my machine gun to DPS her, and then when she lands on the ground, fireball, and then missiles again to force her to jump, and yeah, it's just all that in a loop until she dies. So I say that depending on how a certain fight goes, I would go for another health upgrade. That fight was that one I just did, and it went quite well, so I'm not gonna get that health upgrade, so I should be fine for the rest of the run, hopefully. And here we are in the labyrinth. Which is quite an annoying area, especially the later part of it. Yeah, machine gun makes most of the platforming really easy. Okay, so here I'm about to fight a boss, and I am gonna attempt to one cycle him. Alright, got it. So if you just stand by him and face the opposite direction and use your blade. Sorry, I didn't mention it, but I got the blade earlier, which is like the last weapon of the game. And so the blade deals a lot of damage, but you can only have one blade at once on the screen. And when you shoot your blade, as soon as you shoot it, its hitbox starts slightly behind you, so when you hug an enemy and face the opposite direction, you can actually hit it, because of how the blade works. And this is what I did on that boss I just fought earlier. Alright, here's Monster X. She has a... She has... he has a... Like a... sort of shield, where... you have to damage... four different parts of the shield in order to be able to finally deal damage to him. And looks like it's gonna be a decent fight. Because this fight is actually a hard, like one of the hardest fights casually. For me it was, I remember, it was a nightmare. Alright, so my health is looking good. Yeah, 19 is actually decent. Is Steam version worth buying? I would say no, but it has just like one or two like things that are worth it, that makes it worth it. But looking at the price, I don't think it's worth buying. But if you only want to play like the main game, just download the free version, like this one I'm playing right now. It's translated in many languages as well, so... Alright, here I'm getting an upgraded version of my missile launcher. And unfortunately, it's back to level 1, and during this little area, I'm gonna try to level it up to level 2, at least. Well, not at least, but I must get it to level 2. Alright, this is a really difficult area, and everything does a ton of damage. And I just got through the hardest part of it, so this is good. Oh, it's on sale right now. Like, when I say that there's one or two things that makes it worth it, is like, they added a bunch of different dungeons, like some, you know, bonus dungeons you can play. But that's about it. Otherwise, like, the leaderboards are completely bugged. You can't see them, which kinda sucks, because you can't compare your times. And yeah. Like, in general, I would just recommend this one. Alright. So here I'm gonna do a little puzzle where I have to open a bunch of doors, and I will try to do this little puzzle as fast as I can. And as you can see below, there's water oscillating, like from like up down, and there is a bus in this room, and I will attempt to kill this bus in a way that after killing it, I get the water level to be at a certain point in order to basically go faster. And this is actually very hard to pull off, so we'll see if I can get it. So just before starting the fight, I will just wait it to reach a certain point. Here, so here I just started to speak, to talk to Curly. So Curly is the girl, by the way. And so the boss fight is gonna start now, and I will try to get it done as fast as I can. It was kinda slow. Okay, that was really fast. Ah, shit. I completely messed up the third round, so unfortunately I didn't get what I was trying to get. But it was otherwise a like decent fight, I would say. Average fight, but I couldn't get the expected result. So if I were to kill him really fast, my air level right now would have been much lower, and it would have sped up the drowning section here. I'm just waiting to drown. So if I were to kill the boss faster, I would have basically have less air and then drone much faster. I would say Core, so Core is the name of the boss, and so the Core fight is probably one of the hardest, in my opinion, in the speedrun. not getting the quick kill basically loses you 20 seconds, I think. So I hope I was able to explain it well. It's really kinda complicated, but I try my best. Anyways, next is what I would call the hardest, the most annoying skip in the game. So here's the waterway. There's a bunch of water currents, and there's a specific current here. I almost got it first try. I almost got it here. Okay, I just got it. Good. And so what I was doing here was using my machine gun and aiming up and basically going against the current. Also, I hope you can't hear my phone right now. My phone is going crazy. So I was using my okay. Sorry, I had to mute for a minute. But yeah, I was basically using my machine gun to skip the current by aiming up. And by mashing really fast, you can basically like go through it and be able to skip a huge section of like a maze of currents. And it saves about 15 seconds? Or a little more, but yeah. Okay, so here's Iron Head, giant fish. What I do is stand inside him and just mash. There's nothing really special to it. Blade really does a lot of damage. If you can stand inside a bus and mash it. Okay, so coming up is what I would call the best item in the speedrun. It's called the Booster 2.0, however you wanna call it. And if you remember, I mentioned that in Grasstown I was keeping my horizontal momentum that I got from a fan by jumping on the ground as soon as I touched it. And by keeping that in mind, so the booster allows you to boost in every direction you want, and shit. So by doing what we call corner boosts, which is boosting and touching the corner for a frame and then immediately using my machine gun in order to preserve the speed I get from the booster, sorry. And as you can see, it makes like this whole section much faster. So here's a room where you're supposed to fight a boss after taking that after opening that chest. There is a boss that is supposed to appear, and then you have to fight it. But if you leave the room quick enough, you can just skip it, just as I did. So here's Kazuma. He's asking us if we want the bad ending, and we say yes. We only say yes because it's less text to go through. If we say no, he says a lot more things and it's slower, basically. Okay, here's the outer wall. As you can see, I'm going like from the right side of the area in order to basically avoid a bunch of enemies and stuff by using my machine gun. Okay, so here's the plantation area, and plantation is... Oh, I got this boost, it's a really precise one. And plantation is a really big area, and this is a place where I will use my machine boost and machine gun, sorry, and booster 2.0 that I got earlier to go much faster in it. Like, it's so big that doing all these boosts makes it faster to go through. So then again, when you see me like shooting down with the machine gun, I have booster speed basically. Yeah, Outer World, has a really good music. And I didn't get the backup. Hello? Nice. Yeah, it was completely terrible, but whatever. So now we are going to fight a mushroom called Mapignon, and you have to backtrack a little bit in order to reach him. You have to go through like this early game part. Oh my god, what am I doing? Okay. So he's gonna ask me a few questions. Trying to mislead you, and then he gives you like a fake mushroom, and you have to identify it and realize it's not the mushroom we want. So we're gonna tell him, "Hey, what the hell are you doing right now?" And then he fights you. Shit. Okay, decent fight. I would say it's like average fight. And then you get the final mushroom. The final mushroom turned out to be himself. Yo, I got this boost! It's a precise one. So then again, when I do a corner boost, it's a frame perfect trick where I have to... Where I have to touch the corner of a platform for a frame and then immediately use my machine gun to preserve the booster speed. And right now I can't get a machine boost, okay. So here Curly is talking about a very important part of the story. But it's all in Japanese, so... I mean, I'm not Japanese and I don't really understand it. So my advice would be just play the game yourself with the English translation and find out what's going on. Okay, here's Momorin. She's gonna steal our booster and ask us to gather a few items for her in order to be able to like build her special rocket. So this is kind of the most boring part of the game. There's like 2 minutes of me just going through plantation and gathering the two items she wants. So here I just got a sprinkler. Yes, running the game in Japanese makes it faster. Again, I'm not sure about the difference between English and Japanese, but I've heard it was about 5 minutes faster. And here I'm about to get the last one, the last item. It's a remote control. Wait a sec. Okay, I got it. There's a very important item I need for best ending, and I was wondering if I got it or not. And I indeed have it. Okay, so now I'm gonna sleep, and she's gonna build the rocket, and we're gonna use it in order to reach the final part of the game. But first I'm gonna take my booster back, because I need it. And I'm about to enter the last cave. That's how it's called, but it's technically not the last cave. And when you enter it, all your weapons are de-leveled to 1, so I don't have my level 3 machine gun anymore, so I can't fly. So all I have to do here is basically do a bunch of precise boosts. And this is probably one of my favorite area, because of how it looks when it's done well and fast. Right now I'm doing okay. But touching one of these spikes, it deals 10 damage, so you really don't want to touch them. Okay. Wow, that was a really good last cave. I didn't get hit, like unintentionally, because I do a D-boost at the beginning, so that's good. I don't even need to heal. I'm good. Sorry, I didn't mean heal. I don't need to save. Okay, so now we have a little boss rush. 3 bosses in a row without saves and heal. So here, touching the boss or one of her rotating circles only deals either 1 or 2 damage, so I always try to get hit by them rather than her projectiles, because her projectiles do a ton of damage, so you really want to avoid that. Okay, so now we have the doctor fight. It's in two phases. The first one is really random. He will like teleport at some point. And he can either teleport really far or really close to you. And here he was really nice. And what I do is just stand inside him and mash my blade. And same deal here. I just stand inside him and just smash blade. Blade, once again, blade deals a lot of damage, and since you can only have one blade at a time on the screen, standing inside the boss basically allows you to mash blade. Okay, so here I'm gonna talk to Chaco twice, and when you do that, you get all the Mimigas, like they show their love to you. Oh my god, I can't get there, what the hell? Okay. And actually, I didn't need to heal, but I just wanted to show it off, because it's really cute. I didn't lie when I said the game was really based as hell. It's a cute game. Okay, so here's the final fight of the little boss rush. And we have two other enemies to deal with, but we're only gonna kill one of them. Alright. Was decent. And I don't need to kill the other one because it's no biggie. I know how to deal with her anyway. Oh shit, what? Okay, he's about to die. No, next phase is he's gonna die. Alright, then. Okay, so I'm done with the boss rush, and now I'm about to enter Hell, which is the hardest dungeon of the game, and I'm gonna hope and hopefully get a decent tile room. You will see that the second room of Hell is, like, in that room there is a bunch of rocks falling from the ceiling, and the rocks falling from the ceiling deal 10 damage, so you really wanna avoid getting hit by them. And on top of that, there are a bunch of enemies running at you, and they deal 5 damage. Here I'm trying to get my missile launcher to be at level 3. It's really important for the final boss, what the hell? Okay, so here's the tile room. Everything is random, by the way. Looking good. Looking good. Okay, good. Okay. This is looking really good. Alright, yeah, that was decent. So yeah, that tile room I just got through is a big run killer. Like, dying there is basically means run over. I'm gonna get some XP here. Okay. So here I just... There is a little glitch here where you can shoot missiles through the wall. And I abuse of that to go faster and destroy the next wall. Okay, this is a decent hell. I'm about to enter the boss room. The final boss room, sorry. Also, the boss you just saw, it was basically me standing below him and mashing with missile launcher. Everything happens so fast, I sometimes forget to mention details. Anyways, so here's the final boss. It's in four phases? Yeah, four. And the first phase, I'm just gonna stand inside him and mash with blade. Done. Second phase, I'm gonna stand next to his eye and once again mash blade. And third phase, I'm gonna attempt to get a one cycle by standing on top of his head, mashing blade again, and got it! Yo, that's a perfect fight. I don't even need to use my life pot. So, the last phase, he's very weak to missiles, so you just stand, you just deboost and... Oh, by the way, time. If there is anybody, time, please. So yeah, the last phase. Okay, thanks.
About 102.10.
102.10? Okay,
I think. A little bit late, but yeah.
Yeah, okay, that's fine. So yeah, the last phase, as I mentioned, he's very weak to missiles, so you just stand next to his eye and you just mash with missiles and he's done. So yeah, that was Cave Story, best ending. The world record for this is 57.11, sorry, and I have a PB of 58.50. So basically a time under 1 hour is what I would say a decent time. And I just got 102, which is, I would say, a decent time for a marathon run. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed. Thanks again, Milk, for inviting me for this marathon, and I hope you enjoyed. Next we have Rayman.
Yeah, we got Rayman with the extra.
Nice. That's the run I really want to watch, because Rayman is... childhood game. I really want to watch that. It's a good one. So yeah.
Cool deal, dude.
Yep.
So yeah, we'll be back in just a moment.